Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends, in the last lecture we have studied about entropy and we have studied that how entropy decides whether the reaction is spontaneous or not. And now we are going to study about the second law of thermodynamics, which is based on in terms of entropy itself. So let us talk about that. So now let us learn that is what is a second law of thermodynamics, which is in terms of entropy. So it states that the total entropy of the system and its surrounding increases in a spontaneous process. So this is the statement of the second law of thermodynamics, which is in terms of the entropy. So it says that the total entropy of the system and surrounding, so this entropy of the universe, that is nothing but the total entropy, is equals to the entropy of the system as well as the entropy of the surrounding, and this indicates is more than zero, which means that it will be always be positive. And since delta S is positive, that means the reaction is said to be spontaneous. So this implies that the total entropy of the system and the surrounding will always be more than zero, or will always be positive, which will make the reaction to be spontaneous process. So now, but there are also few criteria where we have to mention that it is not necessary that whenever the entropy of the system, if it increases, then only it would be said to be spontaneous process, or vice versa. So let us talk about that also, so as to understand this meaning of entropy in much more better way. So as I was talking, so it is possible that the delta S of the system, that is the entropy of the system, decreases during a spontaneous process. But what we have learned is, we have learned that during a spontaneous process, the entropy of the system basically increases. But it is not necessary, because if there are also some a few process in which the entropy change of the system is decreasing, or it has a negative value, but still the reaction is said to be a spontaneous process. Or the other term that we could describe in that way, as if the delta S of the system, or we could say if the entropy of the system, if increases during the non-spontaneous process, so even this is also being applicable, because as we know that if delta S of the system, if it increases, it is said to be a spontaneous process. But yes, there are also few process in which the delta S system is being positive, but still it is being said to be a non-spontaneous process. So how it becomes this thing, and what are the criteria that we have to that makes a reaction to be spontaneous or not, depending on the entropy of the system or the total entropy. So let us talk about that also. So the first is, if the entropy of the system decreases, or if we would say that if the entropy of the system has a negative value, and the entropy of the surrounding increases, or we could say if the entropy of the surrounding has a positive value, then the entropy change of the, then the total entropy change, that is delta S total, will be more positive if the entropy change of the surrounding is more positive than that of the entropy of the system, which is negative, which has been considered to be negative, making the process more spontaneous. So let me give an example of that, or by describing, I'll tell you that what is this statement they are talking about. So the thing is, we know that delta S total is equals to, that is delta S of system plus delta S of surrounding. So if they have mentioned that if the delta S system decreases, or if this value is basically negative, so if this is the value which has been negative, and the surrounding increases, which means the entropy of the surrounding is positive, so the delta S total will be more positive, or it will be considered to be positive if the delta S surrounding, as we could see, or the entropy of the surrounding is more positive than that of the system, which has been negative. So if the overall value of the delta S total is positive, then it would be declared as the reaction would be spontaneous. So this depends on the surrounding also. So even though in this case the delta S of the system, or we could say that the entropy of the system, is negative, but still the reaction would be said, or the process would be said to be a spontaneous process in spite of having the delta S system to be negative. So now talking about the another one. Suppose if the entropy of the system increases, or it is a positive value, and that of the surrounding it will decrease because the both are being related to the total entropy. So if the delta S surrounding decreases, then what happens is the delta S total will be negative. But if delta S surrounding is more negative than that of the system which is being positive, so making the process to be non-spontaneous. Let me explain this also. So suppose if I have the value that is delta S total is equals to the delta S of system plus, or we could say it as entropy of the surrounding. So in this case, what they have mentioned is, they have mentioned if the delta S of the system, or we could say that the entropy of the system, increases, or which has a positive value, and in this case that of the surrounding decreases, or if this value is said to be negative. So the delta, the overall and total entropy of the system, or the total entropy, it will be negative if this value that we have, that is the entropy of the surrounding that we have, it is more negative than that of the system which has been positive. So if this value is more negative, then it is but obvious that the total entropy will be negative itself, and because of this total entropy which has now been negative will now be declared as a non-spontaneous process. So based on this entropy also we could decide. So in this case, as we have got to know that the entropy of the system is increasing, or we could say that the entropy of the system is now been positive, but even though being positive, it was being considered to be a non-spontaneous reaction because it was dependent on the surrounding also. So it is not necessary that the delta S is, if positive, is will be a spontaneous reaction. Or if delta S is negative, then it will be a non-spontaneous reaction. So now let us talk about the another one, and we'll analyze it in a much more deep detail. So that is what we are going to talk about. That is, for a spontaneous process, the criteria that we have, that is the total entropy, it should be more than zero, or it should be positive. If the entropy, the total entropy is positive, that signifies that the total entropy of the system and the surrounding increases during the process, because as we have got to know from the second law of thermodynamics, which was based in terms of entropy, if the delta S total is being positive, or it has been more than zero, as we could say in that manner also, if it increases, that eventually they are talking about that the entropy of the system and the entropy of the surrounding, the both are increasing, because the both are sum up of because the total entropy is the sum up of the entropy of the surrounding as well as the entropy of the system. So if the both are been positive, then it would be said to be a spontaneous process. But the spontaneous process finally reaches equilibrium when, which corresponds to maximum total entropy. So in spontaneous process, what happens is the process will reach the equilibrium, in which what happens will be the total entropy will be maximum, because in that case both the system and the surrounding, they both will reach equilibrium, and because of which the entropy would be maximum. But we have the formula also that if delta S total, which is equals to the delta S of system plus delta S of surrounding, which is more than zero. But at equilibrium, what happens is the delta S total must be zero at equilibrium, because we have got to know that if the entropy of a system increases, then the entropy of the surrounding decreases, and they are vice versa to each other. And since when both the equilibriums are being reached at equilibrium, so therefore this will make that the total change in the entropy will now be basically zero. So this indicates that what we have learned in this previous 3 points, that if the delta S total is more than zero, that it implies that the reaction is basically spontaneous. And if the delta S total or the total entropy is less than zero, then it would be said to be non-spontaneous reaction. And whether it has been found that the system or the total entropy is at equilibrium, then in that case the total entropy will be zero, and this will indicate that the process is in equilibrium. So because of the total entropy, we could also decide whether the reaction is spontaneous or not. So let us move on to the further thing so as to understand this concept very clearly. That is, the entropy of the system increases in spontaneous process. That is what we have got to know. Usually we have thought in that way, that when the entropy of the system increases, then it would be said to be a spontaneous process. So it is true, but not in every case. How? Because as you could see here, that however there are many spontaneous processes in which the entropy decreases. In this case, we have, that is, two moles of hydrogen as well as one mole of oxygen gas. If they both combine with each other so as to form two moles of H2 molecules, in this case, what the study has been determined from the study is that the change in entropy, it was been found to be -327 joule per Kelvin. So this is a negative value, and since this is a negative value, so this negative value should imply that this process is basically a non-spontaneous process. But it is not true. This process is actually a spontaneous process, because this hydrogen and this oxygen will combine with each other so violently that this will produce the water molecules with the decrease in entropy, as you could see, because both are being gaseous molecules, and they will come back to a system which is basically more order than that of which is arranged in more order than that of the gaseous state. So which implies that this reaction has been converted from a disordered to an ordered state. So this should have been said to be a non-spontaneous process. But the thing is, this is a spontaneous process, and in this case the entropy is less, or in this case the entropy is negative. So this is what we have got to learn when we have talked about the second law of thermodynamics, as well as we have talked the few criterias which was based on the change in entropy of the system, as well as for the surrounding and overall the entropy, the total entropy that we have got to know now. So that's what I was talking about. So thank you friends for watching this video, and I hope you have understood this video very much clearly, and you'll share this video with your friends too. And yes, don't forget to subscribe to Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.